Well, as the Minneapolis public school system changes and grows more diverse, the district is adding a new program aimed at helping students stay in touch with their culture and language.
Sharon Yu and photojournalist Abdi Abdirahman shows us the impact it's having.
Yeah, he's going to want the coat. We're all going to want the coat.
Bundled up in jackets and donning backpacks.
Good morning. Are you sleepy?
The students at Lyndale Community School leave home to start their day.
Half hour feels like a long time at recess.
We have a lot of Somali American students, African American, a lot of Latino students. We have several students this year who are new to the country.
Kulun. What's another word for kulun?
That, in part, is by design. By now, 1 year into launching the Somali Heritage Program, word has spread that Lyndale is the place kids come to learn in both English and Somali.
Lots of our Somali students at this point were born here, or their parents were born here, and lots of families also feel this disconnect where Somali students don't know how to speak Somali.
You come to a different country, you try to assimilate, you try to blend, and then you grow up kind of regretting forgetting your own culture. And so we want to interrupt that and quickly show them that it is a beautiful thing to have both.
Okay.
And in Miss Farhia Dell's classroom, they have both. Seamless transitions all throughout.
If the parent don't speak English and the children don't speak Somali, they need a translator. They really don't, they won't even understand each other. Purple.
Something they're trying to prevent. At the same time, teaching the kids.
Good job. There's no shame in speaking your language anywhere. Street, bathrooms, I don't care. Do it.
Ultimately, their goal is to have students leave home for another, right here at Lyndale.
In Ms. Rahia's class, so I think Somali's getting better by the minute.
I think it's so important that we connect our school, home and school together. Our children know that they're accepted as who they are.
Just for some context, Lyndale Community School has around 420 students, and a little over 100 of the students are Somali.
Okay. First
cute.
Of all, that little boy, adorable.
Cute.
Getting better by the minute.
But Sharon, we were talking, this really struck home for you, really personal angle for this.
Yeah, for sure. I grew up, I went to an American school, and when I got there, when we were kids, my parents didn't speak English that well. So I was in those exact shoes, and you know what? It makes me feel good that there's a school system that's taking care of the kids who feel the same.
Yeah. Awesome. Pretty
cool.
So much, Sharon.
Thank you.